Thank you. First, I want to thank Emily's List for inviting me to be a part of this incredibly inspiring evening. You know, I have to apologize to Chuck Schumer. I wore a purple tie, but I still want to say hashtag equal pay day. You know, I feel especially lucky to be here as a man who attributes pretty much everything I've ever achieved in my life to the dynamic, loving, and powerful women that I live with and work with and love with every single day. My wife Jane is here tonight. She's first on that list. You know, the impact that of what Emily's List has accomplished in 31 years, first under the leadership of Ellen Malcolm and now under Stephanie Shriok, cannot be overstated. In championing extraordinary leaders like Barbara Mikulski, Barbara Boxer, Carol Moseley Braun, Dianne Feinstein, Tammy Baldwin, Hillary Clinton, and of course, Nancy Pelosi, whom we honor here tonight with the We Are Emily Award. Emily's List has permanently altered the landscape of American politics, bringing us to the point where almost 96 years after a woman won the right to vote, we now find ourselves just 6 months away from putting a woman in the White House. Now, thrilling as that prospect is, we all know that as we approach this historic frontier, the fight against everything that this organization stands for, in fact, so much of what this country stands for, will come under increasingly ferocious attack. Sadly, as we saw with the inauguration of President Obama, the virulence of the opposition we face is directly proportional to the magnitude of the progress we make. For half a century, the right wing in this country, the extreme right wing, has waged a meticulously crafted, profoundly well-funded war to dismantle the legacy of the New Deal and the Great Society, to deprive women of control over their bodies, to end affirmative action, to reject the very notion of climate change, to effectively strip minorities and the working poor of their right to vote, to deny every American the right to feel that they belong in this country, regardless of religion, national origin, gender identity, or sexual orientation, and ultimately to shrink the federal government to such a degree that only the wealthiest and most powerful in our society will have a shot at the American dream. But, and here's the good news, amazingly, no matter how many times they have come at us, the right has failed to stop our momentum. From Newt Gingrich's Contract for America to the Tea Party Revolution in Congress, the neocon movement has failed to make good on its apocalyptic rhetoric. It has managed only to cannibalize the Republican Party, which now finds itself in total disarray, with a reality TV star turned neo-fascist race baiter as its likely standard bearer. And you know, to be fair, we can hardly do a victory dance yet, but we do seem to have them on the run. So how has this happened? How have we managed to consistently foil this epic assault on our democratic values? Well, I got two words for you. Nancy Pelosi. This extraordinary woman entered Congress in 1987 at the age of 46 after raising five children with her husband, Paul. 15 years later, she became the most powerful woman in the history of American politics. As Speaker of the House, Nancy Pelosi presided over the two most productive sessions of Congress ever. Her legislative achievements include the American Recovery and Reinvestment Act, the Lilly Ledbetter Fair Pay Act, health care for 11 million children, the new GI Bill, the first minimum wage increase in a decade, the repeal of Don't Ask, Don't Tell, And most significantly, the Affordable Care Act, where she matched President Obama's Herculean efforts step for step, and where she famously declared, "We will go through the gate. If the gate is closed, we'll go over the fence. If the fence is too high, we'll pole vault in. If that doesn't work, we'll parachute in. But we are going to get health care reform passed for the American people." Well, not only did she get it passed, but she has managed to defend it against a whopping 63 Republican attempts to overturn it. Nancy Pelosi was, to quote E.J. Dionne, one of the most effective speakers in history. Through her relentless hard work, her painstaking attention to detail, her charm, her wit, her profound understanding of arcane political procedure, not to mention her fearsome ability to raise money, Leader Pelosi has managed to unify and focus a diverse and sometimes fractious Democratic Party. Not because it was politically expedient, not because she wanted to win or stay in power. She did it because she knew it was right. You see, Nancy Pelosi has a deep sense of purpose at the core of all her decision making. And she has transferred that purpose, that clarity of thought, to the entire Democratic Party. And in so doing, she has helped bring a progressive agenda into the mainstream of American thought. You know, when asked why she's faced such fierce attacks from the right, she responds without rancor, almost with pride. "It's because I'm effective," she says. "They had to put a stop to me because we were effective in passing health care reform, Wall Street reform, reforms of student loans, and I'm one of the most effective fundraisers that Congress has had because I believe in something." See, that's the difference between Pelosi and so many of her Republican opponents. The Republican Party has been real clear as to what it's against, but it has been unable to articulate precisely what it is for. And as Sam Rayburn once said, any jackass can kick down a barn, but it takes a carpenter to build one. Well, folks, Nancy Pelosi is a carpenter. And now, on the eve of electing our first woman president, we are going to need a master carpenter in Congress. Hillary can't do it alone. She will need Nancy Pelosi at her side because she knows that Nancy Pelosi will always have her back. You know, let's just think about that for a second. Hillary Clinton and Nancy Pelosi on either end of Pennsylvania Avenue. Wouldn't you guys say that that is the ultimate statement about what Emily's List has done for this country? In the next administration, we have the chance to do what FDR did in the 20th century, to make a progressive agenda the law of the land as we set the course for the 21st century. So, Leader Pelosi, I'm sorry, but I just want to say retirement is off the table. Because we need you now more than ever. So let's take a look back at the extraordinary career of Nancy Pelosi.